Now that we're about to start our Kickstarter campaign, I had to dig in deep. I had to do all the research I could in order to figure out how to start a successful Kickstarter campaign. And what I found were three main things that made a successful Kickstarter. And these things were surprising. So now we have to create a Kickstarter strategy. And in my research, what I did is I researched a lot of the different companies who went viral and did really well. And there were three things that potentially happened to make them successful. So the first thing is you need to have an audience when you get started, which kind of seems counterintuitive. I thought you could go onto Kickstarter to find that audience, but in reality, if you want to have a great campaign, you actually need to bring an audience with you. So basically, a lot of these campaigns that did very well, they had YouTube channels, they had newsletters, they were preparing for the launch for a long time and already had thousands, hundreds, or thousands of backers ready to go when Kickstarter launched. Now, the reason this is important, and you might say, like, what's the point of Kickstarter if you need this? Well, what happens is that Kickstarter has an algorithm that in the first couple of days, they're gonna actually look to see how much of your goal you reached at the beginning. So if you launch your campaign, you do an email blast and say, hey, the campaign is live, please come and make your purchase. And then all of a sudden you reach your goal within the first 48 hours, Kickstarter will actually place your project onto their featured products list on the front of their website. And that's where all the new traffic comes from. So if you're buried deep, page 3, 4, or 5, it's very unlikely that they'll find you. You know, there are still campaigns that reach their goal, but I'm talking about the campaigns that went 200, 300, 500, 1000% of their goal, these viral campaigns. And once, you reach your goal early and you're actually on that first page, you can see a lot of traction. That's where you'll see tons of people discovering your product from Kickstarter, and it'll actually make your product reach a goal that's way beyond what you're asking for. Now, the second thing is video. So video made a huge difference. There are lots of different types. So there were some that were very straightforward, but very clear on what the product was and what the purpose was. And there are other videos that were more about purpose. So it had a lot with the founders and explaining like the reasoning behind things. So it was one of those two. Some of the other videos, they're just kind of slideshows or they didn't show like the product, how it could be utilized, they didn't do that well. So the production quality has to be decent. I'm not thinking that we're gonna spend thousands of dollars on the video. You saw the video that we produced. I think it's good enough to just, get people who are gonna be our demographic for that type of product to know what it is. So I think we're good on that. But basically the video is gonna make a huge difference. Now the third thing is outside influence. So what that means is that a lot of these campaigns that went viral, they usually fit the first two criteria. So they had traction at the beginning, they got featured on the Kickstarter website, they had a great video, and then third party, either blogging sites or PR, news sites, took a look at that product and they made a story about it, and it brought a lot more people to look at that product. This really happened a lot with, products that are kind of off the wall. Like there was the coolest cooler with the cooler that had the blender and everything. So things that are kind of off the wall and kind of make a good story tended to do this. And when that happened, you could see the numbers skyrocket. So I'm hoping to do, and this is gonna be our strategy. So I've created a landing page basically announcing that our Kickstarter is coming soon. And you could take a look at that website through the link below. It's getwybo.com. I've created this and I just did some posts, just a few posts on Facebook in some different communities that have to do with user interface design, graphic design, app design, just to see if there was any interest. So within one day, and this is no paid promotion, this is just posting through Facebook groups, we've got about 20 people who signed up to want to know when the Kickstarter is starting so they can purchase their product. So it already showed me that there is some traction, there is some need for the product. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna run a paid campaign, a very small paid campaign, and do a little bit more social media promotion on this to hopefully get about 200 people to sign up. You know, that sounds like a lot of people, but if we did 20 in one day without any paid promotion, I think we can achieve that goal. So if we have 200, I'm assuming maybe half, maybe even less will actually pay the money when the time comes, but still, we'll keep the target of our of what we need to raise very low. Almost so that if we had 100 people make the purchase, it would reach the target. That way, if we do that within the first couple days, Kickstarter will notice that we're a trending hot product and hopefully will feature us on that website. The video, I think we're okay. I use that video to post on the different forums and groups, and it seemed to be working, so I think we'll keep the video. Now the last piece, which is the outside influence, what we're gonna do is hopefully submit some of this information to PR sites and different bloggers who blog about graphic design and app design, and also reach out to influencers. So what I wanna do is hopefully get it to the point where we have enough backers, it seems like there's some momentum, and then suddenly blast the world out there what's going on Kickstarter with this new product. And hopefully we can create some sort of viral effect and then see maybe a 200, 300, 500% reach on our goal. Now, of course, this is kind of all theory. It is exactly what has worked in the past for different companies, but of course the product is gonna be a lot different, you know, for each type of result. Our product is very niche based. You know, if you have a cooler, anybody could buy the coolest cooler, but our product is really based just for graphic designers and user interface designers. So we have a little bit of a disadvantage, even if we're our product is featured on the first page. You know, how many people are actually graphic designers that's going to see it? So we have a little bit of disadvantage there, but I think that if we play our cards right, we can reach our goal and we can make this one of a great product to create us passive income every year. So if you guys are starting a Kickstarter, you know, this information will help you. If you've done one in the past, let me know. Give me some of your feedback too. So maybe you have some great ideas that's going to help us out. But until next time, I'll see you then.